So basically, what we're trying to figure out is how our model changes based on removing variables from the analysis. To figure this out, you just need to remove variables that have too many categories within one predictor variable. So how do you actually do this? What I want to do is start with what we've had built out already, which is the input data tool connected to our select tool, which is connected to our create samples tool. After this part, I'm going to work and tweak our actual model. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in a field summary tool to look at the categorical variables with how many unique values they have within them. What I'm going to do is actually just look for the results for only my different categorical variables. So my customer segment, my income, redeemer, region, and status fields. I'm then going to bring in a browse tool after the I or interactive result. If you look at these different categorical variables, we can see that the customer segment, income, and region fields all have way too many different categories to effectively use with our logistic regression model. The way to deal with this is either combine them into a fewer number of groups, or we should simply just deselect all of it for our model. So in this situation, what I ask you to do is if there's more than four categories, let's just deselect and not use that field for our logistic regression. But what I do want to notice is that our redeemer field and status fields both fit the category and they're good to go. So let's now deselect that field summary tool. I'm going to go back to our predictive category and bring in a logistic regression tool, name the model, and just like before, I'm going to select my target variable as a redeemer field and then my different potential predictor variables, which I'm going to choose as spend, status, stays per year, total days stayed, and years of loyalty. Let me run this model, now reducing the total number of different potential predictor variables, and let's view if the results change at all. As you can see, the R-squared value is now at 0.5865, and as well, we have three statistically significant predictor variables, not including the intercept value. This is definitely one very valid way to determine the optimal predictor variables. Yet, it is a very manual and time-consuming process. Now, what we're going to do is leverage the stepwise regression technique to automate this process.